Hello everybody, EZ here. Today, I'm going to show you how to set up Xbox Dev Mode and install custom applications, such as emulators. Dev Mode is completely legal and won't get your account banned. This is an official sandbox environment you can directly buy from Microsoft. Before we start, here's some important information to make sure you do this safely. If you're a part of the Xbox Update Preview Program, you need to leave it before setting up Dev Mode, or you could risk getting an E208 error, which currently doesn't have a fix until Microsoft releases a new stable offline system update. To leave the program, simply open up the Xbox Insider app, go to Xbox Update Preview, Manage, and Leave Preview. Then, update your console through settings, or wait for the update screen to pop up. Next, when plugging in a USB for the first time, you will be prompted to choose Games and Apps or Media. Select Media. To properly copy ROMs, BIOS files, and more to your USB, you must use Windows. A virtual machine will do the job if you're on a Mac or a Linux machine, but a tutorial for that is out of the scope of this guide. Switching between Dev Mode and Retail Mode will delete your Quick Resume states, as well as your locally stored captures. We recommend using an external USB drive to store your captures. You can do this by going to Capture Settings and changing Capture Location to your external USB drive. Now that you know this information, here's what you'll need to get started. An Xbox One or Series console, a Windows 10 or above PC, and a USB drive for storing your games. Once we have these three things, then it's time to begin. First, we need to purchase a Microsoft Developer account. Click the first link in the description to open up the site and click Sign Up. Select your country. Then select Individual. Now fill out all the required fields. Once you're done filling it out, click Next. Now, insert your billing info. It should be noted that the Microsoft servers sometimes have issues processing payments and billing for Dev Mode. If you receive an error in this step, retry with a new account, payment method, or at a later time. I won't be filling mine out in this video, but the steps from here are pretty self-explanatory. Next, it's time to set up our external USB drive to use on our Xbox console. To use a USB drive with emulation, it has to have the proper permissions set. Luckily, there's a program that will do this for us. First, plug your USB drive into your PC. Then, go to the GitHub store listed in the description. Download the Xbox Media tool. Put it on your desktop and extract it. Now, open the folder and open xboxmediausb.exe. If Windows blocks it, click More Info, then Run Anyway. Now, select the drive you will be using for your Xbox. These two boxes are optional, but I recommend checking both of them. Now click Format USB, then click Yes. Your USB is now fully compatible with your Xbox console. While we have our USB plugged in, we are going to put some games on it. Since we selected Create Default Folders, it will add some commonly used folders to the USB. Now, we are going to add our games. Once we have everything we need on our USB, safely remove it from the computer. Now, let's move to the Xbox. On your Xbox, go to the Microsoft Store. Go to Search and type in Xbox Dev. Select Xbox Dev Mode and download it. When it's done installing, open it. Click Next twice. And you should see a website link and a code. Now we're going to go on our PC and enter this code. Type aka.ms/activateXbox on your web browser. Once it loads, click the plus icon and click Enter Activation Code. Now, type in the code that's displayed on the Xbox. Hit Submit and you should see your console pop up on this page. Now, on your Xbox, you should see it activating. Select Switch and Restart to boot into dev mode. When the console boots up, we will be in dev mode. It may look a little intimidating at first, but we're going to change some settings to make things as seamless as possible. Press the menu button on your controller and select Manage Dev Storage. For this tutorial, we are going to set the dev storage to 5 GB. This will free up some space on the internal drive. Once you've set your preferred amount, click Save and Restart. Now, let's connect the console to the internet. If you use Ethernet, you can skip this step. Press Guide, click Settings, Network Settings, and set up Wireless Network. Once the console is connected to the internet, go back to the dashboard. Now, go to the Test Account section and select Add Existing. Type in the email and password for the account you would like to use. Select Add, and it should log you in. Now, go to the Remote Access section and select Remote Access Settings. Click Enable Xbox Device Portal. You can now access your Xbox from a web browser. If you'd like to, you can check the box next to Require Authentication to set up a user and password for your Xbox. Select Close. Then go to Settings on the left, then back to Home to refresh your screen. You should now see a remote access link on the bottom right of the dashboard. Take a picture or write down this link so you can always have it handy. Now, head over to your PC. On a web browser, type in that link. If you see it's a security risk, ignore that and continue anyways. Now, we're on the Xbox device portal. Here, we can change settings, access files, install apps, and a lot more. Click Settings on the left. Close Device Information and open Power. Change Power mode to your preferred mode. For this tutorial, Instant On. Then uncheck these two boxes. When prompted to restart, click Later. Close Power and open Preference. Change Default Home Experience to Retail Home. And check the box next to Treat UWP Apps as Games by Default. Close Preference and open User. Change Auto Sign-In User to your account. Now, click Power on the top right and restart your Xbox. Once your Xbox turns back on, it should look like retail mode and automatically sign you in. Now that dev mode is set up, it's time to install some apps. Head over to your PC and go to the GitHub store linked in the description. Before you download any games or emulators, download SafeExit. Next, download whatever else you would like. For the sake of this tutorial, we are going to download Dolphin. Put these files on your desktop and extract the zip files. Now, we have Dolphin and SafeExit on the desktop. Open up a web browser and enter your Xbox device portal link. Now, click the green Add button. First, we will install SafeExit. drag in the Safe Exit APEX file, and click Next. Some applications may require dependency files. Safe Exit is an application that does. It's worth noting, not every homebrew application will require dependencies. Go back to the Safe Exit folder and open the Dependencies folder. Drag each of these files one by one, then select Start. Safe Exit has been installed. Now for the other applications. For this tutorial, we are going to install Dolphin. Everything is now installed, and it's time to head back over to the Xbox. Go to My Games and Apps, and you should see your installed apps. Now you can play all your emulators to your heart's content. And when you are done, and you would like to go back to retail mode, simply select the Safe Exit app. And when you want to re-enter developer mode, open the Xbox Dev Mode app and select Switch and Restart. But before we finish, we will show you how to use the Dev Portals File Explorer to connect to your Xbox over the internet. This is useful for accessing your app data. For example, we want to use this configuration file for Aether. So, we are going to click File Explorer, Local App Data, and Aether SX2. I'm now going to navigate to where this configuration file goes and delete the original file. I can now drag the new file onto the Browse box and select Upload. And the file is successfully uploaded. Thanks so much for watching this video. Hopefully it has helped you understand how to utilize Dev Mode on your Xbox Series or Xbox One. But if you have any more questions, feel free to ask in the Emulation Hub Discord linked in the description. Be sure to leave a like, comment your questions, and subscribe for more emulation-related content. Take care!